Hello to all the people out there. Thank you so much for watching Medical and Nursing Knowledge Hub. Today we will going to discuss on a very important topic from nutrition and biochemistry, and important from your exam point of view, whether it is written exam or any competitive exam. Yes, we are going to discuss the topic vitamins. And as we all know, one or two questions or MCQ are always expected from this topic, whether they are asking another name of any vitamin or sign of any deficiency or rich source of any particular vitamin. Or it is not only important for your exam point of view, but also for our day-to-day life or for our proper growth and development. So we will see vitamins. So first question is, what is the meaning of vitamins? Yes, these are the organic molecules that are essential for normal health and growth, or we can say normal growth and development from birth to till older age. These are the cofactor for many enzymatic reactions. As we all know, so many enzymatic reactions take place in our body for metabolism, whether it is food metabolism or anything. So they act as a cofactor, and these are not like produced in our body. These vitamins should be essentially supplied in diet. Means these are the vitamins which we have to consume in our diet. So then the question comes, why they are good for us, or why they are essential, why there is need to consume these vitamins? First thing is to improve immunity, because immunity is the most important part of our body functions. So second thing is to prevent from so many illnesses, and to slow the aging process, because so many vitamins got the function of healing, repair of epithelium tissue, and so many things. Then the types, as we all know, they are broadly classified into two types. First thing is fat soluble, second thing is water soluble. So in this video we will gonna discuss the fat soluble vitamins, and in our next video we will be discussing the water soluble vitamins. So if we will see, then they are starting from vitamin A to vitamin K. In fat soluble the vitamins are A, D, E, K, and in water soluble they are broadly divided into non B complex and B complex. In non B complex there is vitamin C, and in B complex they are mainly two types, energy releasing or hematopoietic, in that B1, B2, B3, and that we will discuss later on. So what is the meaning of fat soluble vitamins? As I already told, they are mainly four, A, D, E, K, and its name suggests fat soluble vitamin means they are soluble in lipids but not in aqueous solution, means they are not soluble in water, they are only soluble in fats and lipids. Then they are important for vision, bone formation, antioxidant, and mainly blood clotting, jo mainly vitamin K ka kaam hota hai. And they are stored in our body only, means once we consume that, they will be having some stores in our body. And opposite to that, water solubles are mainly excreted by urine and other sources. They are not stored in our body. So we will start one by one or fat soluble vitamins here. So first thing is vitamin A. As I already told, sometime MCQ में क्या पूछते हैं इनका दूसरा नाम, जैसे vitamin A का जो biological name है that is retinol, and it is obtained from beta carotene in plants. Even sometime it can be asked like, what is the precursor of retinol? So the answer is beta carotenes. Function. What is the function of vitamin A? First thing is it has many role related to eye, GI system, respiratory system. We will starting from eye. So first function is it help in dark adaptation, means it help in our color vision. So and second function is it helps in protection of corneal and conjunctival epithelium, and the main function is dark adaptation and protection of corneal and conjunctival epithelium. Means there is deficiency of retinol, then it will lead to night blindness. Then it can lead to dryness of eye, and it can lead to hyperkeratinization. Night blindness is due to a problem in dark adaptation, and dryness of eye or hyperkeratinization is due to because it will not able to protect the cornea or our cornea or conjunctival epithelium. So sign and symptom for xerophthalmia means dryness of eyes. WHO have given the various stages for xerophthalmia, or we can say those stages which lead to blindness due to deficiency of vitamin A. So first stage is X1A, X1B, then X2, X3 in that further classified X3A, X3B and then XS and XF. So in first stage, in very first stage, that is X1A, that will lead to conjunctival xerosis, means dryness of conjunctiva, then it will lead to formation of bitote spot that I will show in picture. Then in X2 stage, it will lead to again corneal xerosis. First conjunctival xerosis means dryness of conjunctiva, then dryness of cornea. And in X3 stage, it will lead to keratomalacia. First I will get dried, and after that there will be softening of cornea. The softening of cornea is known as keratomalacia. It will further classified into X3A and B. In X3A, the cornea will only 1/3 cornea will involve, and in X3B, more than 1/3 cornea will involve. And then in later stages, XS, it will lead to scarring of cornea, permanent scarring, and in XF, that will lead to fundal changes. And the most important thing, till X2 stage, if deficiency is there and these symptoms have appeared, then it is reversible by giving treatment. But after X2 stage, these are non-reversible, means X3, XS and XF, because there will be so many changes and the people will ultimately lead to be a blind person. As you can see in picture, first stage is conjunctival xerosis, then bitote spots, means there will be calcification, then corneal xerosis. Corneal xerosis means it will involve the cornea, inner part of our eye, then it will lead to corneal ulcer, and ultimately after keratomalacia, and then later stages like scarring of cornea and fundal changes and permanent blindness due to deficiency of vitamin A. Then another function of vitamin A, and another function of vitamin A is protection of skin, and other function like gastrointestinal and respiratory epithelium protection. So if there is a problem or deficiency of vitamin A, then it will lead to dryness of skin, and mainly in HIV/AIDS patient or person, it will be seen like toad skin, or toad skin means excessive scaling or dryness of skin. And if a person is having deficiency of vitamin A, then it will lead to so many frequent and recurrent respiratory and GI infections. Then comes to the sources of vitamin A. If we want to prevent the deficiency, though, obviously we should be knowing the rich sources of vitamin A. So first thing is any fruit or vegetable having color orange or red, like carrot, apple or pomegranate and other food, tomato. Then comes to the like papaya, meat, egg, cheese, fish, apricots, peaches, melons, apples and other food. These food are rich in vitamin A. And as we all know, vitamin A deficiency can be in anyone, means in children as well as in older people or adults. So to prevent its deficiency, our government used to supply the vitamin A supplement to the children starting from 9 months to 5 years of age. So first dose of vitamin A is at 9 months. That is, the dose is 1 ml or 1 lakh international unit, mainly by oral route. It is the oil of vitamin A. And then second dose of vitamin A will be after 9 months of first dose, means at the 18 months, and then after every 6 months up to 5 years, there will be frequent vitamin A supplementation given to the children. And till 9 months, there will be 1 lakh international unit, and after 9 months there will be 2 lakh international unit will be given out, 2 ml mainly oral route. So this is mainly to prevent vitamin A deficiency. Then comes to the next vitamin, that is vitamin D, and another name of this vitamin D is cholecalciferol, or hum journalists mein isko kya bolte hain, sunshine vitamin. Synthesized in skin when our skin exposed to sunlight. Yes, mainly sunlight means the UV radiation. Then the function of vitamin D is it mainly regulates the absorption of phosphorus and calcium during bone growth, means it helps in bone mineralization. And the rich food rich in vitamin D is mainly dairy products, fish, egg, meat and other fortified beverages, cereals, and means the thing which consists mainly calcium. Then it is important for our bones, our teeth and our so many parts of body. So vitamin D is very essential. If there is deficiency of vitamin, then what will happen? As we know, it is required for bone mineralization. If it will be lacking, then it will lead to decrease in bone mineralization and start bone demineralization. So that then it will lead to decrease in bone mineralization. And first thing can be rickets, osteomalacia, osteoporosis, genu varum, genu valgum, and windswift deformity. Rickets mainly seen in children, then osteomalacia in adult people, and osteoporosis mainly in menopausal female. And signs you can see on your projector. Then the most important condition is fourth and fifth, genu varum and genu valgum. Very important from your exam point of view. Genu varum means bowing of legs, means it is the most common deformity seen in children due to vitamin D deficiency. And in genu valgum, there will be no knee. And in windswept deformity, there will be both condition, genu varum and valgum. We will see in pictures. Like first, you can see the angle of knee are normal. This is the picture of normal paper. Then second thing is genu valgum. Genu valgum means no knee. As you can see, the knees are facing each other. And another condition is genu varus, in which the deformity is like knee, the angle of knee is opposite to each other. Then another picture, as you can see, and in third picture, this is the picture of windswept deformity, means genu varum and valgum exist together. Then in rickets, as you can see, normal bones are looking properly. There is no tiny deformity in normal bones, and they are looking, there is no swelling, no deformity. But in rickets, the bones seems fragile, there is swelling, and there is bone deformity due to rickets. So the next vitamin comes the tocopherol, vitamin E. The vitamin E, it is the most powerful antioxidants in our cells. We know antioxidants are required to kill the free radicals. The function of vitamin E is to improve immunity and cures muscle, heart, skin disease, and burn. Its deficiency mainly seen rare, but if it is deficient, then it will lead to hemolysis and posterior column defect in preterm. And rich sources for vitamin D is green vegetables, vegetable oil, corn, egg, bread, dairy products, peas, beans, etc. Then comes to the vitamin K, the last vitamin of fat soluble. The vitamin K is, it can be obtained from plant or animal. If we obtain it from plant, then it is known as phylloquinone, and if animal, it can be known as manaquinone. The main function is mainly for clotting factor, formation of clotting factor. And the clotting factor which is formed or synthesized from this is factor 2, that is prothrombin, factor 7, that is co-thromboplastin, and factor 9th and 10th. And it is given to the newborn as a routine newborn care, to mainly to prevent bleeding. And the sources are green fruits, vegetables, tomato, beef liver, yolk, wheat, and the one. And in routine newborn care, it is mainly given at the time of birth. The dose varies from 0.5 to 1 mg, and the preferred route is IM, means to preterm we used to give 0.5, and to term baby we used to give 1 mg, just to prevent bleeding, because the liver is immature, that's why we used to give at birth. Daily values or requirement you can see on your projector. Then, okay, in summary, in today we have seen various fat soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, and K, and all these are very important, and their deficiency or excess can lead to problems. If you like this video, please give a big fat thumbs up and subscribe my channel, so whenever I post any video, you will be notified. And we will gonna see the water soluble vitamins in our next video. So till that, stay tuned, have a nice day. Bye bye.